Merab Dvalishvili wants Sean O'Malley to keep saying he won. Merab Dvalishvili is playing mind games with Sean O'Malley ahead of their rematch. The bantamweight champion wants O'Malley to continue saying that he won their first fight, as it will help to build up the hype for the rematch. Dvalishvili has also promised not to kiss O'Malley this time.
He won this fight, and listen, I don't have reaction. I'm not mad. I mean, actually, I want to him promote this, and I want to more people believe this, and I want to fight him because, like I tell you, I will not kiss him this time. I will try, you know, I will try because I like him, and sometimes, you know, but this time I will finish him, you know, I will finish the fight, I will finish business. I'm not gonna listen herd in, you know, and I'm gonna go for a finish, you know.
Ilia Topuria versus Merab Dvalishvili superfight on the horizon. Could we see a superfight between Ilia Topuria and Merab Dvalishvili in the future? Both fighters are on a collision course, and the potential matchup has fans buzzing. It's a fight that would have major implications for the bantamweight and featherweight divisions. Topuria blasts Habib's cousins for cheating. Ilia Topuria has unleashed a scathing attack on Habib's cousins and teammates. The Georgian fighter accused them of cheating and using steroids, and he also took a shot at their fighting abilities. It's a bold statement from Topuria, and it's sure to ignite a rivalry between the two camps.
Hablabas de los daguestanís y parece que todos han querido entrar a la guerra, una batalla dialéctica que tenías tú con Islam, pidiéndole, ¿no?, que en un futuro resolváis vuestras diferencias dentro del octágono. Ha entrado Usman, ha entrado Abubakar, que son primos de Khabib Nurmagomedov, ha entrado incluso Belal. ¿Cómo ves esta situación? Porque parece que quieren ir todos a ese choque dialéctico.
Mira, una cosa que respeto sobre Khabib, de verdad, el tipo es de verdad súper respetuoso, ¿sabes? Nunca dice nada de nadie, la gente habla un montón, él nunca dice nada de nadie. Yo he mencionado a Islam y han salido los primos que nunca jamás han noqueado a nadie, los pillan por esteroides, son súper tramposos y de repente saltan. Lo único que me indica es que tienen el sistema nervioso dañado por tomar tantos esteroides, porque es lo primero que daña, ¿sabes? Amenazar a un peleador con cuando nos veamos te voy a pegar, es como, chico, me dedico mi vida a la pelea, ¿sabes? Que sea un poco más creativo. No sé qué puedo decir. Su mejor es Islam.
Topuria targets three-weight world championship. Ilia Topuria has set his sights on becoming a three-weight world champion. The Georgian fighter plans to move up to the lightweight division and then the welterweight division after retaining the featherweight title. It's an ambitious goal, but Topuria has the talent and the drive to achieve it.
So in 3 years,
yeah,
when you're 30,
yeah,
and me and you sit down again and we have a conversation, what will you have achieved in that three-year period?
Probably a three-weight world champion. Yeah, this is my goal. Yeah. You're not gonna see him in the welterweight division like this, skinny. You're gonna see me different. Yeah, that's the goal. More up to the lightweight division, get that belt, and then more up to the welterweight division.
Respect between Topuria and Volkanovski. There is mutual respect between Ilia Topuria and Alexander Volkanovski. The two fighters have praised each other's skills, and they have expressed their admiration for each other's accomplishments. It's a refreshing change in the world of MMA, where rivalries often turn personal.
What's up?
Right.
You feel all right?
You good?
Good, Lane?
Yeah, everything's going good. What about you?
Yeah, good. Oh, there's a lot of cameras, man. There's a lot of cameras, huh?
Volkanovski believes Topuria deserves Fighter of the Year. Alexander Volkanovski believes that Ilia Topuria deserves to win the Fighter of the Year award if he beats Max Holloway. The former featherweight champion praised Topuria's level of competition, and he expressed his belief that Topuria is one of the best fighters in the world.
But I mean, if Ilia goes out there and does his thing, mate. You know, that's very impressive. You know, obviously taking myself out and Max, the two guys that have been on top of this division for so long. It's impressive, you know what I mean? And, you know, he'll be right up there for Fighter of the Year. You know, he's maybe not as active as some of the other guys, but the competition is...
Diego Lopez arrives in Abu Dhabi as backup fighter. Diego Lopez has arrived in Abu Dhabi as the backup fighter for Ilia Topuria versus Max Holloway. The Brazilian fighter is ready to step in if either of the main event fighters is unable to compete. It's a precautionary measure, but it's also a reminder that anything can happen in the world of MMA. Ngannou responds to Jones showing respect. Francis Ngannou has responded to John Jones showing respect to him after his victory. The heavyweight champion praised Jones for his class, and he also expressed his interest in watching Jones' upcoming fight against Stipe Miocic.
John Jones tweeted about your victory. Did you happen to see that?
Yeah, I saw that. I saw his tweet.
Okay, we'll show it. What did you think of it? Here it is. What an amazing job Francis did tonight. Displayed a complete MMA game. Great kicks, great takedowns. It feels good to see him shine. Wow, congratulations, champ. I see you.
Yeah. Well, whatever it means, I think it's class. He said in a very nice way, you know. So I see him too. And I'll be watching him on November 16th.
That's the one, man. That's the one that everyone says. Why not? They're both with ESPN. Maybe Turkey has a hand in it. Do you think there's any chance this happens in 2025? You versus the winner of that fight or the UFC heavyweight champion?
There's a chance. I can't tell on the level of 1 to 10. I can't tell how many, but I know there's a chance. I mean, basically, like, I know that fight also interests Turkey, and no many team resisted him.
Official poster for UFC released. The official poster for UFC has been released, and it features a star-studded lineup of fighters. The event is headlined by a heavyweight title fight between John Jones and Stipe Miocic. It's a must-see event for fans of MMA. Cormier praises Khabib for loyalty. Daniel Cormier has praised Khabib for his loyalty after the Russian fighter said he can't befriend John Jones because of his feud with Cormier. The former UFC light heavyweight and heavyweight champion believes that Khabib is one of the most loyal people he knows. He stated, "Khabib is one of my favorite people in the world. He's just the best and most loyal person you could meet." Khamzat training with Dzurukian for UFC. Khamzat Chimaev is training with Armin Dzurukian in preparation for his fight against Robert Whittaker. The two fighters have been training together for several weeks, and they are both confident that they will be ready for the challenge.
Yeah.
Khamzat promises to finish Whittaker. Khamzat Chimaev has promised to finish Robert Whittaker. The Swedish fighter believes that Whittaker is not hungry enough to compete at the highest level, and he is confident that he will be able to dominate the former middleweight champion. He stated, "I'm gonna finish this guy. He's not hungry like me. He's not that kind of fighter like me. It's a big difference. I am ready to show Robert I'm the best." Israel Adesanya reacts to Francis Ngannou's brutal KO. Adesanya offers his thoughts on Ngannou's devastating knockout victory over Ferreira, highlighting the power and precision of the strike.
Good patience, yes, yes. Oh, oh! Let's go! Let's go! Woo! Wow, that was beautiful. I feel that, man. I can imagine how it feels right now. That's for Kobe. Y'all must have forgot, bro.
Francis Ngannou dominates Renan Ferreira. Ngannou delivers a first-round knockout, showcasing his incredible power and finishing ability. The heavyweight division has a new champion.
Feet. Ngannou's positioned himself. Knees on the outside, feet on the inside. And he is unleashing thunder from... Oh, he's out! He's out!
He's in big trouble! And he's down! And he is done!
Francis Ngannou honors late son with knockout victory. Ngannou dedicates his victory to his late son, Kobe, revealing that the memory of his son motivated him to fight and win.
Not anything than my son, Kobe, you know. I only take this fight because of him. I wanted to fight for him, but about that. And I'm done, so I don't know. I hope they can remember his name, because without Kobe, we wouldn't be here tonight. I wouldn't have fight, but thank you everyone for coming.
McGregor loses betting against Ngannou. McGregor admits to losing a significant sum of money on Ngannou's loss, but remains confident that he'll recoup his losses in the future. McGregor, wrestling heavy MMA is boring. McGregor expresses frustration with the prevalence of wrestling-based tactics in MMA, calling for more striking-focused fights.
Come here, look around, fuck off, Liz. Wow! Wow! Oh my God, no! What the hell? Oh my God! What? Wow! Oh my God! No way! No way! Oh yeah! What? No way! This can't be happening right now! Oh my God, he has him! He's holding him, guys. How's he doing this? Oh my God! This game! Fuck off!
Paul Hughes calls for title fight against Usman. Hughes demands a match against Usman, setting up a potential sequel to their highly anticipated first encounter.
Fired up, Paul Hughes, obviously saying you're a superstar. I want to get to that, but first off, it was a split decision in here. What was going through your mind as the scores were being read?
It's hard. It's hard when you're actually the one fighting to know the score. Judging from the energy around the arena, everyone I was looking at and AJ's face, I think it was pretty clear that I won that one. I mean, there wasn't once where he nearly got me out of there. I nearly had him out of there a few times.
Split decision, but it's a win over AJ McKee, and you're just screaming into the camera, you're a superstar. How did you feel about your overall performance tonight?
Damn right. The PFL believed in me, and look at me now. Look at me now. I'm here on the world stage. I took the risk. I fought one of the best guys on the planet. Here I am, a young kid from rural Ireland, on the big stage. I believe that I doubled down on myself. Oi! Saudi Arabia.
You were putting on a show all night. If you want to just look up there, we're going to take a quick look at some of these highlights, many of them coming on the feed. This, I believe, is at the end of the first round.
How many times did I hurt him? A lot of times. A lot of times. Who's done that to AJ McKee? That knee almost took him out in the first round. It was a split second away. And I'll tell you what, that was not one of my best performances. It may have looked all right. I was completely gassed after that first round. I didn't have the best training camp coming into this. And I tried to put that out of my mind and deliver. I had to dig down deep for you all tonight to get that win.
What a statement sent to the world tonight and to the rest of the lightweight division of Bellator. Congratulations very much.
One more thing. At the end of the day, we all know who we want to see next. We want to see Ireland versus Dagestan number 2. We want to see Paul Hughes versus Usman Nurmagomedov for the Bellator lightweight belt. And I think we should do it in Dubai, or else let's bring it to Belfast. Let's go!
Ladies and gentlemen, Paul Hughes.
McGregor shares intriguing video. McGregor posts a mysterious video on his social media, showcasing Topuria's imitating capabilities outside the octagon.
You say send location, here he is right here to front you.
I'm here, right in front of him.
Do something about it.
You sound shit.
Kamaru Usman versus Jack Maddalena, verbal agreement. Usman and Maddalena have agreed to fight at UFC 312 in Sydney, Australia. The matchup promises to be an exciting clash of styles. Ilia Topuria ranks fighters' tattoos. Topuria offers his brutally honest opinions on the tattoos of various fighters, including Max Holloway, Josh Emmett, Sean O'Malley, and McGregor.
I've got four fighters here. I just want you to rate their tattoos for me on a scale of 1 to 5, okay?
Okay.
First, we got Max Holloway's angel tattoo here.
The wings. Actually, I like them. It's like maybe 4.
You're going to at least give him a 5 or so. That might be the nicest thing you've ever said about Max Holloway. All right, what about Josh Emmett? He's got this colorful sleeve around the shoulder.
I don't like that kind of tattoo, so I have to tell you 1, because I don't like the colors.
Okay, you're not a color guy. Well, then I think you might like this one even less. If Josh Emmett is a 1, what are we doing with Sean O'Malley's owl here?
Disgusting. And with that body, even more. That looks okay. Disgusting.
All right, that's, yeah, sorry. Shout out to Sugar Sean. Last
minus
one.
-5.
Poor guy. All right, shout out to Conor McGregor. We mentioned his tiger tattoo. What about the gorilla on the chest?
Fuck.
Okay, who had the worst chest tattoo, Sean O'Malley or Conor?
I have to say Conor.
All right.
Because I don't like him.
Fair enough.
Ilia Topuria's custom shorts steal the show. Topuria's unique and eye-catching shorts for UFC become a talking point, generating buzz and admiration. Ilia Topuria. Volkanovski was much tougher than Holloway. Topuria reveals that he found Volkanovski to be a more challenging opponent than Holloway, citing his experience and fighting style. He stated, "Volk was much tougher than Max Holloway. He was much tougher, much more experienced. Even the style was a little bit more difficult for me than Max Holloway's style. I don't feel any danger from Max Holloway. He's not good in the ground. He doesn't have that knockout power. He's a fighter of a lot of volume, but that's it." UFC to host event in Spain soon. Topuria confirms that the UFC is planning an event in Spain, potentially taking place in April. McGregor goes crazy over the moon. McGregor expresses his amazement and excitement about a futuristic experience, comparing it to the Sphere.
Nah, here. The phone isn't doing this justice, folks, yeah? Get out and have a look at that moon quick. Is it the moon is on the bleeding low level. It's like the moon. Surely the moon's gonna go up. Look at the thing. Have a look at that moon, folks. Quick. LJ in there if you can. That is the maddest. It's like the Sphere. It's like I'm looking at the Sphere, yeah? What? What the fuck? Nah. What is with these phones, man? Look at that moon quick, everyone, yeah? And tell us. Is it going up? It's actually going up. That's usually the moon's up there, like. It's down there. It's at me eye level. And it's huge. And it's going up. Yeah, look at that moon. Can you see that? That's rising up now, look. Oh my God, it's the Sphere. The Sphere's outside, folks, yeah?
Song Yadong versus Umar. Fight in the works. Song Yadong's coach, Yurija Faber, confirms that a fight with Umar is being discussed.
We don't have a date for that yet. I don't think December 14th is the date that we've talked about. I think maybe January is what we're looking at, but we like that fight. You know, I think both Umar and Song are guys that people don't want to fight, you know, and so they're both willing to step up. I think that's a good fight. We'd fight O'Malley, we'd fight Figueredo, we'd fight any of these guys, really. But yeah, they've been talking about that fight. I saw all sorts of stuff posting about it. Nothing's been signed. That date has not been agreed upon. If that fight does happen, I think it would likely happen in January.
Okay, UFC 311 in LA?
Yeah, that would be the one that I think would be the most likely.
Max Holloway rejects Ilia Topuria's forced fight claim. Holloway refutes Topuria's assertion that the UFC forced him to fight, pointing out that Topuria himself expressed interest in the matchup.
I mean, it's just, it's funny, you know, like he says that, but then you can go and click. There's an interview of him saying that he won't fight me if the BMF title wasn't on the line. And the last time I checked, the BMF title is not on the line. So if anybody got forced to fight, it looks like him. You know, it came out of his own mouth. He said he's not going to fight me unless the BMF title is not on the line. And it's not, buddy. So I guess he played himself on that one.
Max Holloway warns fighters against misusing his point down. Holloway emphasizes the importance of staying aggressive and swinging after executing his signature point down move.
That's kind of become like a move that you're known for, though. Yeah. The point down to the ground.
To leave a mark like that in a sport that's always growing is always amazing. And if you want to keep on doing the point down, but just remember, guys, when you guys do the point down, it stay there and swing, not point down and take a couple steps back, you know?
Right, you have to make sure they do it exactly correct if they're going to use your signature move.
Dricus du Plessis receives hilarious cake. Du Plessis receives a playful cake featuring crying faces of Adesanya and Strickland, poking fun at their rivalry. Sergey Pavlovich teases return. Pavlovich shares a training video hinting at his upcoming return to the octagon. Volkanovski backed Max Holloway. Volkanovski predicted that Holloway would defeat Topuria, citing Holloway's ability to outwork him on the outside.
Again, he's a heavy puncher. He does have good grappling and that as well. I think he used to be a Greco-Roman, but I think Max's deep takedown defense is going to be too much if he tries to take it there. I don't think he's going to have any success. I think it is going to be on the hands. Max is going to know that he can't just sit in the pocket with someone like Ilia Topuria. I think he's going to, you know, be able to outwork him on the outside. Five rounds with Max Holloway isn't easy, especially when you're, you know, a pocket rocket looking for that power. Look, he might catch him, but I think it's going to be a long, hard night for Topuria. And that's not me knocking the guy. It's just obviously I've fought Max three times. I know how good the guy is. I know how you need to prepare for that guy. You need to be ready for five rounds of war every single time because he's coming. And you're going to crack him hard. He's going to keep coming. Even when things aren't going his way, that third fight I had with him, the last fight I had with him, I felt like nothing was going his way, but he did not come off to us. He was just coming the whole time, and that's just the type of guy. I think he's just going to be a little bit too much.
Tom Aspinall predicts Ilia Topuria knockout. Aspinall believes that Topuria has the power to knock out Holloway in their upcoming title fight.
But the threat's there, and sometimes that can bring you your defensive boxing. That can affect your defensive boxing a little bit because you're thinking about the takedowns, the hands are low, you're getting ready for a shot all the time and punches are coming over the top. I think I'm going to go out there and say Ilia Topuria can put him down. He's got the power to and he mixes it up so well between the disciplines. I wouldn't be surprised if Max Holloway got dropped in this fight.
Do you think we'll see a fight of the year contender?
I think it's definitely, it definitely could be up there for a fight of the year. I can't wait for it. I'm looking forward to it.
Robert Whittaker, ready to hunt down Khamzat Chimaev. Whittaker vows to take the fight to Khamzat, expressing confidence in his ability to overwhelm him.
Where do you think you're better than Khamzat Chimaev? Where do you think you're going to be able to stand out in that fight?
I definitely like to put faith in my striking ability. And the fact that I'm going to go in there and I'm going to hunt him down, I'm going to take the fight to him. And I don't think you'll be able to stand up to that. I don't think my wrestling defense and the caliber of my striking is going to give him an easy night. You know, I can also fight from the first second through the 25th minute. So right. I hope he's ready because I am.
Robert Whittaker claims to be in his prime. Whittaker believes that he is a better fighter than ever before, having reached his physical peak and refined his skills.
Do you feel like you're a better fighter you were on the night you lost that last title fight to Adesanya, or do you, you know, like physically you're probably not as good, but mentally are you better?
I think physically I'm better as well. Well, yeah, certainly. Like, I'm 33 at the moment. Like, I feel like I'm really just hitting that prime sort of, stride in my game. And one of my ultimate objectives with my craft has been to better it, to perfect it, to really just, you know, tighten the nuts and bolts. And I feel that every year that happens, every fight pushes me closer to that goal. And every year I get more wise, I get smarter, I take on board new ideas, new ways of doing things for the better.
Max Holloway. This new era is mine. Holloway dismisses Ilya Topuria's claims of a new era, asserting his dominance and experience as the former champion.
Since I've been with the UFC since I was 20 years old, everybody think I'm like 50. So it's crazy, you know? At the end of the day, people keep saying that this new era is about to start and this and that and blah, blah, blah. Ilya Topuria is like 29, I think, I believe. I'm only 32. I turned 33 at the end of the year. I'm like, this new era, I'm stood in this era. I am stood here. Just because I've been around longer than him doesn't mean I'm an old guy. So the last time I checked, I was younger than Ilya and I had title defenses, so.
Max Holloway, Ilya Topuria, doesn't get the gist of it. Holloway blasts Topuria's point-down offer, calling it foolish and questioning his boxing IQ. The former champion insists on fighting with strategy and skill, not recklessness. He stated, "I don't think Ilya gets the gist of it. The point-down is something you do towards the end of a fight. If something's going good, if the fight is entertaining, or if you're winning, you give the other guy a shot. The moment is a moment for a reason. The belt is called the baddest motherfucker. If the belt was the DMF, dumbest motherfucker, then maybe I would have got sucked into it." Talks about being a boxer. That's not very much boxer IQ-ish of him. Max Holloway warns fighters against point-down misuse. Holloway clarifies his signature point-down move, emphasizing the need to stay aggressive and swing after delivering it, not retreat. He stated, "Just remember when you guys do the point down, it's stay there and swing, not point down and take a couple steps back." Hamzat Chimaev versus Robert Whittaker, a clash of titans. Both Hamzat and Whittaker exude immense confidence ahead of their highly anticipated showdown, with each claiming superiority in different ways. Opens up about his mental struggles. Ngannou reveals the devastating impact of his loss on his mental health, admitting that he questioned his toughness and faced immense grief.
You know, they've been telling me that I'm tough to the point that I get to believe that I'm tough. And then I recently just find out that I wasn't tough. I wasn't that tough, you know? Like, life can let you take an advance and think you're running away, and then it hits you really bad, like from the front. And then, you know, it's something that I never imagine. I mean, I never know how I feel. I have seen people going through it, and then I even, out of compassion, I even trying to understand like how he must feel, but never get anywhere close to how he feel exactly.
Obviously, this is something you've had to think about, deal with your entire training camp. How bad or hard was it today to focus on the fight itself?
It was pretty hard, you know. He was hard at any moment from the beginning to the end, but I think it's one of those things that you kind of like ask yourself, is this gonna be ever be over? And you think he might never be over. You just might as well learn how to roll with it, to live with it, because in certain case, I would have take time, you know, to grieve. But how long would that take? I don't think there's enough time for me to do that. I don't think a lifetime would be enough to grieve. And so is it just about like keep going, you know? It's a new life that I'm, new way of living that I have to learn.
Francis Ngannou, "I'm still learning to deal with this." Ngannou humbly acknowledges that he's still grappling with the challenges of his loss and is unsure if he can offer advice to others in similar situations.
You're in this horrible position where you can give people advice about this. If someone is in the same situation as you, is that the advice you would give, just one day at a time, just step by step and try and make it through?
I don't think I can give somebody advice because I'm still expecting to have advice on myself how to deal with this kind of situation. But yes, the only thing that I know right now is that I've been taking it one day at a time.
Kamaru Usman, thrilled by Francis Ngannou's knockout. Usman expresses excitement and admiration for Ngannou's dominant victory, highlighting the power and skill that made it possible.
He took one too many.
Ian Garry calls out Kamaru Usman for dodging a fight. Garry accuses Usman of avoiding a fight at UFC Tampa, comparing him to Colby Covington and demanding a match. Usman tweeted, "I'm ready to slide." Garry responded, "Ready? Really? I thought you were built different, but turns out you and Colby are more similar than I thought. Say yes. See you December 14th. McGregor to support Paul Hughes against Usman. McGregor's potential presence at Hughes's fight against Usman adds a layer of intrigue, especially considering the rivalry between McGregor and Usman's cousin, Habib. McGregor tweeted, "Paul, my man, I will go to the arena and support 100% for sure. And if it kicks off, I'll be in there before you could even say, the Nurmagomedovs are juicehead inbred rats married to their cousins. Your team and corner have done a tremendous job with you. They will take you all the way. You've got this. We are with you, brother. Bring home the gold." Sean Strickland confirms rematch with Dricus du Plessis. Strickland has agreed to a rematch with du Plessis, although the location and date have yet to be determined. The highly anticipated rematch promises fireworks. He tweeted, "It's happening. Location and date not confirmed." Tom Aspinall predicts Ilya Topuria will knock out Max Holloway. Aspinall offers his take on the Topuria versus Holloway matchup, predicting that Topuria's striking power will be too much for Holloway to handle.
"So being a bit of a shorter guy, what he does really well, Ilya Topuria, is shorter arms. So with this fight, he's going to be looking to get inside. And the body hooks, the low kicks, and the shot in is what he's looking for. Because he's got like a low center of gravity, especially, he says that Max Holloway is 5'11". Mate. He's at least 6'1". So with Ilya Topuria being the shorter guy, he'll be looking for the right hands over the top, the left hook to the body, and the shot and trying to hold him down. His defensive boxing as well is incredible. Look, he'll throw shots.
He's got the old Philly shell going there.
He's got the Philly shell going, but his chin, and this is something that I need to work on myself, he's constantly tucked. So he'll throw his shots, and he'll come out of there, and like you say, he'll be behind the shoulder with his chin tucked, and then he'll go back in, look. See how he just comes straight back in? So Max Holloway, complete contrasting style. The only similar thing is they both like to box. Max Holloway's style is, he'll have his hands quite low and his chin quite high, as we talk about with the taller guys. And the guy will come, 3-4 punch combinations, step off, back in, step off, back in. And because of the height advantage in this, he's most likely going to be going this way. As he's stepping off, because Ilya Topuria is much shorter than him, a lot of the punches I would imagine will be missing. But this is the important thing when you talk about the balance and the footwork. Can Ilya Topuria get his feet in time with such a tall guy like this? Is the volume of punches that he throws in a fight is unbelievable. The guy's got ridiculous conditioning.
Do you anticipate with the grappling of Topuria that he is going to revert to it at some point in the fight?
I think he's going to keep him guessing with the takedowns, yeah. And okay. I think
it's hard to take him down though, isn't it?
It is. It really. But the threats are there. And sometimes that can bring your defensive boxing. That can affect your defensive boxing a little bit because you're thinking about the takedowns, the hands are low, you're getting ready for a shot all the time and punches are coming over the top. I think I'm going to go out there and say Ilya Topuria can put him down. He's got the power to, and he mixes it up so well between the disciplines. I wouldn't be surprised if Max Holloway got dropped in this fight.
Thanks for watching. Smash the like button. Don't forget to subscribe.